You're here to see me talk about the Nike Jordan Why Not 0.3, but I'm also going to talk about Kyrie 5s and Kyrie 6s because I just cannot help but see the overlap from the Kyrie 5s and the 6s and this upcoming release of the Nike Jordan Why Not 0.3. So stick around to find out where those two sneakers come together in the latest from Russell Westbrook. This is a Tokyo Butter 23 Sneaker Channel. Tokyo Butter 23 Sneaker Channel Days. Mainichi Upsuru no Day, Mainichi Miteku no Sai. Every single day I'm bringing you content from Tokyo, Japan. Every day, daily sneaker content about sneaker reviews, sneaker news, and upcoming sneaker releases. And what we're looking at today is the Nike Jordan Why Not 0.3. I did review the Nike Jordan Why Not 0.2s, and I'll put a link to that right here. Ding! And if you want to check that out. And I am fully behind this sneaker and the basketball player Russell Westbrook, who comes out with this collaboration for the Jordan line. I think he's a great athlete, great basketball player, great personality. Love his shoes, but this version, this 0.3, I see too much of the Kyrie 5s and the Kyrie 6s in them, and they're not unique enough for me. And I'm going to tell you where I see those overlaps and where the points are that come between those two lines of sneakers in this upcoming release of Nike Jordan. Why not 0.3? But before we do that, shout out to the Son of Some Man. If you know who the Son of Some Man is and you've subscribed to his channel, great. If you don't know who he is, I'm going to put a link to his channel in a minute after I've told you two things about him. One, he does sneaker in-hand reviews, which is a dream of mine for my channel. So he's a senpai for me, and I would love to see him do well, and I'd love to get to his level. So the Son of Some Man, sneakers in hand. Two, he has a massive Jordan collection, absolutely iconic Jordan sneakers. So you definitely want to check out this man right here. Ding! The Son of Some Man is a great guy, and we're trying to help him out this Christmas period. So I think I've called him out 5 days in a row now or something like that. And he is a Butter Movement guy, and the Butter Movement guys, we play a video, and I have to give you a hint. We don't play a video, we play a game. And the hint is, this is hint number 5, back to front, upside down, inside out. That's the hint to go with the other 4 hints that have come in the previous videos. If you don't know what that's all about, here's a link to that video's explanation about how that game goes. And if you want to understand the game, that's it right there, but we don't want to waste time on that. So let's get into today's sneaker, this Nike Jordan Why Not 0.3 from Russell Westbrook. First off the bat, it's an extremely colorful sneaker. You can see that straight away. It's also quite a big departure from his previous 0.2 line. The 0.2 line for me was all about sort of blocking, where there were blocks of colors, but this right here, and hopefully you can see it behind me right now, it's all about almost like splatter coloring, just random colors, hits of color all over the place. So the 0.2s more focused in on that kind of blocks and different places on the sneaker with solid colors, but you can see these guys here, there's a lot of different places with a lot of different colors popping, hits of colors, design, all that kind of stuff everywhere on the sneaker. So it's a pretty an evolution, a departure from the 0.2s. Now, where I see it tying up with the Kyrie 5s and the Kyrie 6s, we'll stay with the colors and talk about the Kyrie 6s. The Kyrie 6s came out with an awful lot of colors, a lot of colorways, one silhouette, many, many different colorways. And it's that color sort of, I don't know what you'd call it, evolution into these more bright or bold or popping colors that I see the tie up between the Kyrie 6 and these 0.3s. Hopefully behind me here, you'll be able to see a picture of a Kyrie 6 to get an idea of what I'm talking about with the colors. And it's more to do with the kinds of colors than the color blocking, if you like. The Kyrie 6s, most of them have tended to be a sort of dual color colorway, two colors playing off of each other, but they have got an awful lot of color combinations going on. And that's why I see a tie up between these 0.3s and the Kyrie 6. But it's the Kyrie 5 that really, really is the place where I see more than just an echo. It's more than just a hint to the Kyrie 5. It's an awful lot that's kind of close together on that. Now, before I tell you that though, this is a YouTube channel. So I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it fast. Like, subscribe, comment, and share the heck out of this thing on social media. And as I am here in Tokyo, Japan, I do say in Japanese at the start of every one of my videos, Toroku yoroshiku o negai shimasu. Iine mo kuriku suruto tasukaru node, comment mo nihongo de kaite kureruto kansha shimasu node. So back into this sneaker, I am trying to sort of shrink down the amount of channel talk time and increase the amount of sneaker talk time. Hopefully I've done that well in this video. You can tell me in the comments down below if I haven't or if I have. But without further ado, yes, this sneaker and that tie up to the Kyrie 5s. The Kyrie 5s were a really big echo of ancient Egypt. My favorite sneaker that I go to all the time when I talk about Kyrie 5s is right here. It's the Iket from 2018. It's probably a year ago now that I reviewed that sneaker with that pop and purple sole and those sort of sandy colored upper on there. But they're really big echoes of ancient Egypt, which are carried through onto the Kyrie 6s. But with the Kyrie 5s, the signature thing that I want to look at is those sort of triangular pointy areas on the sneaker. And if you look at these 0.3s, with any luck, you'll be able to see those pointy lines that are an echo of the Kyrie 5s. And that for me is where, it's an issue I had, to be honest, though, full disclosure and all that, it's an issue I had with LeBron sneakers, that LeBron sneakers seemed to echo Jordan sneakers too much, and they weren't unique enough on their own, with the exception, in my opinion, of the 17s. I think the 17s are absolutely unique shoe, and I think they're beautiful. I'm looking forward to doing a review about another 17 later in this week. But the Kyrie 5s, you know, it's a thing with the LeBrons that I didn't like. There was too many echoes of the Jordans in there, and then here we are with these 0.3s, and I think there's too many echoes of the Kyrie 5s in there with those sort of sharp triangular lines where the midfoot strap comes across and things like that. So I don't know if there's, you know, crossover with the design teams or if they share elements in the design process or something like that. But for me, it's just a little bit too close to the Kyrie 5 for my liking. That's not to say it's not a popping sneaker. And with Russell Westbrook behind it, it wouldn't surprise me if these guys are going to pop and fly off the shelves. Now, speaking of the man himself, there are places on here where you've got some signature detailing, and they're in two different ways. You've got the RW for Russell Westbrook, but then you've also got the Y knot for his signature sneaker. We'll start with the Y knots on those, the toe, right on the toe wrap, the front part of the sneaker where the midsole, the outsole comes up and wraps onto the toe. You can see it written in there. Now, the thing I like about this, hopefully it's clear to you here, it's not easy to see, I admit that. It's not easy to see the Y knot here on those toe rolls because they're almost like they've been written by a kid or something like that. They're kid language rather than computer language or design, you know, put on there with purpose. They're very much, I don't know, they're random if you like, but I like that. I think it's cool. I reviewed the, was it LeBron 7 Christmas last week? And if I did review the LeBron 7 Christmas last week, here's a link to that. Ding. And one of the things I liked about it was on the toe roll on the front of the sneaker there was it had, I think it was 20 and 3 on the two different ones. And then on the lace holders that had LeBron and James. And I like it when they have different things on the left and right sneakers. And here we've got on this one, the Y knot on the front there in that colorful over the top outsole from the 0.3 line. But that's the first place with the Y knot. Now the second place where the Y knot branding comes in is that lateral branding that you should be able to see behind me here on the lateral side of the sneaker. And I'll zoom in on it and hopefully you'll be able to see quite clearly that the Y knot. So there's the two places where it really pops out for me with the Y knot branding. But then there's also the Russell Westbrook, the RW branding, which is easy to see at the bottom of the lace system. If you pan down to there with that square RW on there, but also on the medial side, you'll also find a hit of Russell Westbrook branding on there as well. So all in all, you know, you've got those Y knots in two different places and you've got that Russell Westbrook branding in two different places. But you've also got the Jordan branding, because remember, these are a Jordan. And I do have a little piece of me that doesn't like it when other athletes jump on the Jordan line. It's like, have your own line, you know? It's one of the things I appreciate about Kobe is that he had his Kobe Pro Tros and things like that, his own line. And I think, you know, Russell Westbrook would do well to have his own line. The Kyrie's being a good example of that. So that aside though, you do have the Jordan branding on there, especially notable up on the tongue where you've got a white Jumpman on a grey tongue to signify that this is in actual fact a Jordan sneaker. And that all in all is pretty much the sneaker as a whole. It's primarily, it's grey in its base, but because of all the popping colours on there, it's the colours that dominate it with that top lace line, the pinks, the volts. It's volt is the colour of the season, so we call it volt. And then if you flip them upside down, as I said before, you've got that popping outsole on there in a multitude of colours. Even though it is like a base grey sneaker, it's the colors that are really drawing your eye because of the The richness of them, the hot, that's what they call them, hot colours. They're just so hot that they really draw your eye, even though it is primarily a grey sneaker. So all in all though, like I said, I'm a bit struggling with that, you know, the overlap between the Kyrie 5s and here the 0.3s. Let me know in the comments down below if you agree, if you totally disagree with me and you say, what on earth are you talking about? Feel free to stick that in there as well. It would be great to hear. But these guys, they're dropping on January the 2nd, so they're not too far away, and people will vote with their feet. And if they like them, they'll go ahead and buy them, and it doesn't matter what I say. Or I might be right, and people will be like, you know what? I loved the 0.2s, but these 0.3s, not really my thing. Either way, we'll find out in a couple of days' time when these guys drop. For now though, it's time to sign off. Thank you guys for checking out my content. A little bit about the Butter Movement. I had a good long chat with Shoe Butter at the weekend, and we were trying to work out things that we want to do for the channel. And I said there's two things that I want to do, and I realized that there's a third thing I have to do. The two things that I want to do is I want to keep going with these 2-minute videos on the weekend. If you haven't already checked them out, they're part of this playlist right here. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, that playlist contains some of the rarest sneakers in the world, like Stewie Sixes and Graffiti Eights and things like that. So definitely check out that playlist. So I said I want to keep going with those 2-minute videos that I get every Sunday from Shoe Butter. I also said that I want to go down and see him and shoot some video in the shoe apartment. Yes, yes, win-win. These are great things to have happen. But then when I was talking to him, I realized, you know what I have to do is I have to ask the Butter Movement guys themselves. Butter Movement guys, really, what do you want? What do you want from me, and what do you want from Shoe Butter? Like I said in my previous videos, we've gotten, you know, Butter Movement 2.0 sort of up and running, but now we need to know what we're going to do with it. What would you like me and Shoe Butter to do with this? So let me know. I mean, obviously we'd love it if you came back, gave us daily content, like 20 minute vlogs every day, but that's a bit much to ask. But within the, you know, within the parameters, within the confines of reality, what is it you guys want for Butter Movement 2.0 and from Shoe Butter and myself? Let me know in the comments down below. For now though, it's time to sign off. Thank you guys for checking out my content, as I do every single day. I truly appreciate you guys being here, and because I am here every single day, it means that I can confidently tell you that you're guaranteed to see me tomorrow.